In today's video, we're going to talk about page object models and how to implement page object models in Python. So first, I'm going to introduce some background information about page object models. So what are page object models? Well, it's a design pattern in automation testing, which creates an object repository to store web UI elements. So the reason we use page object models is because it can help us overcome code duplication, it can make our code easier to read, and it makes it easier to maintain and reuse our code. Now, how do we do page object models and how do we use it? Well, the general structure that we follow is we create these classes of pages, and we basically segregate web UI elements in those classes. And then we also have a class of tests, different test classes, which basically call functions from the class of pages. And so it kind of segregates the two different elements in separate folders and separate classes of stuff. But this will be a little bit more clear once I show you how the project structure we have. So let's look at the diagram in the next page to sort of understand this more. So we have classes of pages, which basically have this right here, and this contains UI elements and different web functionality testing functions in this class of pages. And then the class of tests basically call those pages, it calls those UI elements and it calls those functions, and it tests the pages. So how do you run page object models in Python, Selenium? Well, you're going to have to use the Selenium page factory library. And this is the library that we'll be using in today's video. And these are some different methods that you can use in that are supported by this library. So there's set text, get text, clear text, click button, double click, get list item count, and so on. And you'll see us use these later on in the video when I show you the code. Okay, so I opened my project right here for page object models. So I'm just going to give a quick overview of this whole project structure. So this is the page object model structure right here. We named the whole folder, the whole project, page object models. Within there, there's two subfolders. There's SRC and there's test. In SRC, we also created another subfolder called pages. And these are three different scripts that we have under pages. Now under test, we just have three scripts itself. So this is the general structure of this project. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go to pages. So within pages folder, this contains classes of pages. And within tests, this contains classes of tests, as we mentioned before. So I'm going to open one of the pages. So let's open login because it's the simplest. And this is the code we have. So I'm going to give some few key things that you should notice. So the first thing is we're importing page factory right here. And then with page factory, there's a few things that we have to be aware of. The first is we're always defining a class right here, and we're always passing page factory as an argument. And within each class, we always have an initialization function right here, which initializes a driver. Also a few things, two more things to note is within each of these classes, there are things called locators. And these locators, they essentially have the name of the locator. So it's like web elements. And then it has whether it's an ID or XPath, and then it's actual location. So here we have the sign in, the username, the user password, and the link login. Now below that, we have functions. Now these functions and methods, what they do is they test specific things on these pages. For example, here, this tells it to click the sign in button. And as you can see, it calls the sign-in locator using this syntax right here. So self.signin, because we define sign-in here, .click, and this click is a method from page factory. And so we do that for select username, select password, and click login link as well. So this is a very simple example of it, and it can get a little bit more complicated as we move on to the other examples we have. So this is login page. So this is the class of page for login. Now we have the class of tests. So within these class of tests, we have login, for example. And again, this is a simpler one compared to the other two. But what we do, you see, is we import time, we import WebDriver, we import ADM page. And now you see we're importing ADM page by using src dot pages, and then we're using login page. So we're importing this, and then we're importing the class ADM page, which we define right here. So with that, we have our test function. So within our class, so this is very similar to what we write previously. So we specify a driver, we maximize a window, we go to the URL, and then we wait, and then we pass the driver into this class. So we initialize this class from what we defined earlier, and then we run each of the functions within the class, and then we quit. So let me show you how this looks. So I'm just going to run it from here. So I'm going to go ahead and run Python test. And it opened a window on my other page, but I'm going to drag it over, and we'll see what happens. So yeah, so it logs in like we expect it to. So it should close by itself, so give it some time. And now we see it's done, and it's finished running. So that's the login. So now we have two other things that we can look at. We have the golf page and the booking. Let's go to golf page first. So I'm going to close the other two. And this one is a little bit more complex. But again, what we're more focused on is the structure and how you can run this yourself, and not really the specific example. So I'm going to gloss over some of the details, but just really give you the key points. So the first thing is, again, we're passing in all these different functions, libraries, and most importantly, we're passing in page factory. These two ones, libraries, we're just passing in because we need it for some of our tests. Again, we initialize a class, we pass page factory, and then we have the initialization function, locators. There's a lot more locators for this one. And then different classes, different methods that basically run different things. For example, this one, it selects the password. So it finds the user password and it sends the password key. This one, for example, it'll check if the text in this address cell is equal to whatever country is here. And then we have some other ones. For example, this one adds a golf course. So it fills in all the form with all of these elements, and then it'll basically submit it. And this is the one that uses action chains. If you're not familiar with, you can look at action chains in our previous videos. And this one is for deleting a golf course. But yeah, so this is what we have for the class for golf page. And then in the test class, this is what we have again. We're importing golf page right here. We're also importing ADM page. And some of you might be like, why are we importing this? Well, this is just specific to our example here. The reason we're importing ADM page is because in order for us to add a golf course and delete a golf course, we're going to have to log in. So basically, this relies on the previous one that we showed. And so we're going to have to log in. So that's why we have ADM page. But really, what we have here is what we're testing here is the golf page functionalities. So deleting a golf page, adding a golf page, and so on. In this test function, unlike the other one, we have four different tests that we can run. And you can run these individually by going to here and clicking this play button. One thing I want you to note is that if you run all four at the same time, you can just go here and run all four at the same time. But I'm going to run it one by one in this video. So let's start with test one, which is enter golf search. So essentially what this does is this searches for Tiger Golf, and it finds Tiger Golf and sees if it's there. So let's go ahead and run this. So drag it over. And then you should see in the search bar, it searches for Tiger Golf, and we see it finds Tiger Golf. So the next one, this is select country. So there's a filter option on the website, which lets you filter golf courses by country. And so we can select them for Canada, and we can see if any of them find Canada. So let's run that again. Again, we'll drag it over. We see it filters by Canada up here, and now everything is within Canada. And then this third one, this is for adding a golf course. So this is the really long one. And then the fourth one is for deleting a golf course. So I'm not going to run these because it's not very that important. But I'll just show you a little bit about how this is done. So again, we see that we're specifying the Chrome driver, maximizing the window. We're going to the URL. And then we're instantiating the class for golf page. And then we're also instantiating the class for ADM page so that we can log in. So after we log in with ADM page, Now we use golf page and to add a golf course, and then we test that. Same thing down here, except this time we're deleting a golf course. But yeah, so this is for golf course. Now let's move on to the third and final one, booking page. So again, same structure. The import statements are hitting up here, but we're importing page factory. We're passing it in to our class, and then we have initializing installation definition. We have locators, and then we have different test functions. Coming back to here for its test class, we see that we only have one test, and what are we doing? Well, book golf course. We're basically booking a golf course. And we're searching for the golf course, we're finding it, and then we're booking it. So let me run this and show you how this looks like. So open it up. And we see we're booking a golf course. But yeah, so that's page object models. Just to summarize, because I want you to leave with the key points. The first thing that we have to do is we have to create classes of pages. Within classes of pages, you have to import page factory, and then you have to create a class and pass page factory. You also have to have initialization function, locators, and different methods to test functionalities on your page. And then with the class of tests, basically what we're doing is we're just calling that class that we have and different methods within it so we can test different functionalities on that page. But yeah, this is page object models. I hope you found this video helpful. If you like this video, please give this video a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for listening, and we look forward to seeing you next time.